kind of things like that. So at least started recording. It's not me who started recording.
Is it okay if I record this call?
Oh, sure. I don't have any problem.
Okay.
Consent. You have our consent.
Yeah. So, hi everyone. Most of till SPYM is the same what I did. For a long time I was interested in public health. So I was thinking I should probably move away from clinical medicine and then get into public health. That was the kind of division I thought existed. But after I joined SPYM and I saw the doctors there actually doing both, in their clinic as well as outside clinic, I thought it was public health was more of an attitude, and since I also like seeing patients, I continued to do that and see I'm exploring how I could actually try to do both. Right now what I'm doing is working with Akshay and another colleague on a project for actually trying to improve primary health care for the transgender community and women and sex work community in Bangalore.
Amazing.
Yeah, that's great. Good to know.
Yeah, Shavit, you want me to share this screen?
Yeah.
So fine. So Swati is a bit sleepy, so I'll just drive this conversation. Okay. The thing is, there is a definite lack of quality primary healthcare in our country. Although, Asad was with us yesterday and we discussed this, and he said the healthcare system in India is not very bad, that it is okay compared to other countries like say US where it's very expensive, or some countries where you do not get to see the doctor you need without a wait for a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks. So he says there are pros and cons of Indian healthcare system, which is okay. If there are pros, no issues, but then there are still cons that we can address. And I think many of us will agree that one of the biggest cons of our system is that the primary healthcare system, and by primary healthcare I mean a comprehensive way of treating talking about health, in which which has two concepts. One is medical care in the sense quality care that is continuous, comprehensive, connected, and then all over there's a point of contact between a patient and a provider, and then there is a continuity of care between providers and communication and all that. That is medical part of primary healthcare to talk about. And then there is also the bigger or broader and equally important social determinants of health, which are influenced by policy or rights or economics or caste or gender or whatever things that can influence health, which are not really addressed by many of our healthcare practitioners or providers. And I wouldn't say it's not just the responsibility of just healthcare providers to think of all those, but at least healthcare providers should be thinking about all those, because they are actually healthcare providers. So, and their definition of health should be at least consistent with WHO definition of health. That's the context in which we need to build a strong primary healthcare movement within India and all over the world, but at least within India. And I think what we believe is that is possible if we start, doing things ourselves, like rather than waiting for someone else to take the initiative, or it doesn't even matter if someone else who is more powerful or who has more money or more resources start doing things. Like if the government decides, they just recently introduced the NMC bill, and they may probably do more good things towards improving primary healthcare. But that shouldn't prevent us from doing our own bit. And this kind of, I mean, the, from the discussions we have had in the past with Savinita, Swati and me, and inputs from a lot of others about their views of primary healthcare, what we have been thinking of is that there should be a movement of, what was the point? Yeah, we should be doing things rather than complaining. And that should be a group, that there should be a movement or a group of people who can inspire each other.
I can't hear you guys. Like,
can't hear at all.
No, a bit. Like, just now it's fine again. There was some disturbance.
So the idea, the entire idea of the movement as such, or the small group or community we are building, is that people should be able to do things on their own, and they should be feeling empowered or supported, or have a social circle from which they can draw inspiration towards doing things on their own. I think that kind of summarizes what we mean, what we mean by primary healthcare movement. I mean, primary healthcare can mean a lot of things, and it can be like, it can mean everything on earth if you look at it like that. So this is the specific niche of things that we are trying to kind of build.
What I just wanted to add was that, like Akshay just said, right, it's going to be a group of individuals who proactively work on an issue to address one public health issue, and because we stay as a group, right, we can, he said inspiring. I'd just like to add to that that we can also learn from each other's methodology, like how Akshay and Swati are working on improving primary healthcare to women who are sex workers. Like, that's a useful methodology to learn from them, to raise different questions, to implement it on the field whichever we are, we're also working on. So that's a good movement to build forward, right? Because we are all in the same age group and we work in diverse sections. Yeah, that's what I also see the utility of this group as.
Yeah, Savinita, I actually wanted to point out the same thing. Like, there are people, young and old, who are doing a lot of things, but we come across each of them only as a matter of chance. So, or we read about them or we meet them somewhere. But if there's a group where we can actually keep adding people who are doing such kind of work, which can itself become catalytic and bring in more people and inspire people,
like
yeah, that's true. Like, if we have a strong group, as in if we don't disconnect with each other, we're gonna stay for a long time. That means we'll discuss more methodologies, like she was saying. That's one thing. Either like you can use all of this group to yourselves, like helping yourself in your career, or like with some like good idea sometime in future, like with these people, like, I mean, with you guys, we can build or do something. It's like for in future, but right now, like what she said, that's true. Like, we should learn from each other.
Yeah. And it's also, it's empowering more if you say that you're a part of the primary healthcare. If you say you're a part of this movement, right, when you introduce yourself saying that, it gives a more, it gives you more identity, it gives you more accountability or empowerment while issuing any public health issues. Like, that's what helped me actually. Like, I wanted to attend an event and addressing that I was a part of this movement, right, it gave me more leverage. Even though the group is still invisible and not fully fledged, but yeah.
Anuradha, any thoughts?
What is what are your thoughts after listening to all these?
That's great. Like, whatever you guys told, but what I feel like I should add is, like, we should go, like, we should have a plan, right? Like, say, like, what are we going to achieve through that group? Say, like, we have a group, like, helping each other, having a conversation, that is great. Like, anyway, when you guys are always there, like, whenever we have some doubt or something, if you guys give some homework to us, or like, or you guys have a plan, like, how to go about it, this moment, like, what are we even looking at? Like, say you inspiring the UG students to know about it. We are a skillful people. Already we finished our like MBBS course. Like, what we can do our bit practically. Like, what exactly the plan? That's gonna help. I think so. Having some plan, probably working on some things, specific things. For now, I don't see, like, there is a group, yeah, we have conversation, we will learn about it, that isn't all there. Like, in future, as it progresses, I feel like we should have a plan, like, or a goals or whatever.
Yeah, I agree with you. Without a plan, I think it will be very abstract and also...
Specific goals, like, say, like, teaching us all the group mates about the things. Like, we should know about it. How can we go about it? Like, something like that. A specific goal would help us a lot. That's what I was thinking.
Do you want to answer that? Or...
No.
So, one thing is, there is definitely a specific goal, at least in my mind. And I think when we are discussing Swati, Savneet and I, it was quite clear that we all think alike about what we were talking about, you know, Cheryl. At least for me, in my mind, doctors and you, Anuradha, you just pointed out the same thing. Doctors don't know how they can help or how they can.
Yes, true. That is so true.
Part of the movement, and I'm not saying movement as in our movement kind of thing. Primary healthcare is a global standard that everyone should be aware about and everyone should be able to do on their own. So why a movement just around a concept that is in textbooks? The thing is that many people need that guidance and handholding to figure out what needs to be done differently from what they're already doing. And that is where, at least for now, at least we have built the manifesto, or we have put in initial words on what a manifesto should be. And this actually is a part of this call also. We should discuss what is the manifesto and what needs to be there, what more needs to be there. So things like what defines primary healthcare or what defines contribution towards that movement are clearly laid out or should be clearly laid out in the manifesto. And what that will enable anyone to do is read that. And not just doctors, whoever is interested in health, primary healthcare or health in as a concept, they will be able to read that and figure out something that they can do in their own capacity towards that bigger goal. And that's the kind of manifesto we are building. And that, we already have done a great deal of writing, and I think I'll just share the screen. And that will kind of help. So before I share the screen, the idea behind all that is that people who are clueless find some clue and go about doing something at least. But that shouldn't restrict what the movement is capable of or what the movement is about. The movement can be defined by individuals in whatever capacity they have, like, I'm thinking of bigger than what we are aspiring it to be. So if someone believes that it needs to be something even bigger and are taking in that direction, there should be nothing preventing the them to be doing that. So that's that's a different concept altogether. So I'll just share the screen, and so this is the vision is very simple. Quality primary healthcare to all. Is visible? Shall I zoom in?
Can you better zoom in?
Yeah.
So let me try 200%. This is the vision. Very simple. Quality primary healthcare to all. And it's not a goal as such, like you have to do this in by 2025 or 2030, and it is probably a never-ending thing. There will always be new challenges, and there will always be people doing things. And this is just the direction that we are going into. And this is the mission.
Yeah.
So mission as such is, I think, can you, Savanita, explain this?
Hello?
Yeah.
So when that mission is there, right, to motivate individuals to become leaders, like, because Anuradha told, we are kind of in our MBBS, we are not taught how to like go further and tackle many evident health issues on our own, right? Like, we just forget that demanding primary quality healthcare is like, it's our right. We kind of never thought that. We just think that we're doing a favor to like patients or something. So what I think is that, you know, this will help all of us, like seeing each other's work, it will motivate us and, you know, it'll give us ideas to tackle health issues in our own way, whichever, like, because you might be, Anuradha might be further doing surgery, and if she sees a public health issue, right, which is very prevalent, we can like share ideas and share problems. We can like work together, like some ways in which we can go further as a team. That's what I, how I see it. And second, it's, yeah.
It's all the mission.
That's
the principles are also there. Let's go.
Yeah. So to add to that, actually, Anuradha, you asked the question like, what will the goals be, what will be achieved through this movement, right? So basically what the movement is trying to do is actually build people, as in building people is primary thing which we think will be key for quality primary healthcare, and that we could do through several ways. That is what we should probably discuss about in terms of what activities we would do as part of the movement, so that we can enhance this learning, we can learn from each other and motivate or bring changes. Like, for example, like she said, if you have an issue that you want to work on, but there is no enough support, we can write together, we can help each other out in those ways. And that is what I feel might be the directions in which this movement would head. So who are we? I think we are a community of people taking the responsibility for quality primary healthcare. So for example, if there's some issue, instead of a single person probably writing a blog post or just discussing with a friend, wouldn't it be more powerful if we have a group of people who can come out with a document saying what should be the mode of action in that situation, what could have been done better in terms of like to advocate for a change or to actually do something about it. I think that is what the community stands for.
So also, things where an individual is probably confused and not sure whether that is the right thing to do, or cannot find a tribe of people who are doing the similar things, and you know, the mainstream thinking or traditional route career paths are all pointed towards a direction which is not really helpful for the cause, which is quality primary healthcare. I say this only because I am biased towards the traditional career routes, in that they all end up in the traditional systems and structures, not because that is a wrong path, but the attitudes and the systematized values that are inculcated in that traditional career path are not really, actually, when we go through our values, you may be able to see the difference between the problem in following these traditional systems and why there needs to be a alternative, not really an alternative, a direction or a goal or a common movement which can help people inculcate those values also in their lives, and then spread those values in the traditional systems, and then transform the system. So the question is, how do you transform the system? And I mean, the answer, there may not be a single answer or a simple answer. And this is one attempt at an answer which may help in one direction. So many people are doing it from the direction of, you know, either government top down direction, where government is pushing into the system better values, where the government themselves may not have the credibility to advocate those values. And then there is a system where people, anyone else who is not directly part of the system, trying to tell the people in the system to do better. So this is kind of a ground where it starts within the system, where people within the system feel like they need to change and change happen. So that's the kind of direction that I think this movement is headed towards. Does that make sense? Or
yeah, it does.
How are you guys finding about all the things discussed so far? Like, it does seem more of hand waving right now, but I guess so I'd like to say that as we start working, the coherency will come. So and I think it's important that it's all stated here, so that, you know, this, we would imbibe all this value. So do you guys agree?
Yeah, absolutely, I do.
Yeah.
But to me, primary, when you talk about primary healthcare in India, India really gets divided by rural and urban. Urban has all secondary and tertiary healthcare, but there are more number of people in rural area, but we have more doctors in urban area. So when you really divide India into rural and urban, so we are not utilizing more workforce, like as in more doctors, if we are more capable, like out of, let's say, 1.5 lakh people who write UPG exam, other than 20,000, like what are others doing? They are like concentrated in secondary and tertiary healthcare, or they are preparing for UPG again, or they might be doing nothing else, because there are actually many doctors in India. Like we keep complaining, but I feel like what Akshay said, like transferring or connecting primary healthcare to doctors, that's more important, because by not doing this, we are not utilizing the other sect of people, that is rural people. We're not utilizing their land, not utilizing what doctors are capable of, at least like MBBS graduates. Like if you keep yourself, you are narrowing your field of interest. That's very good for you as an individual. But you, when you talk about primary healthcare, what I really feel is you really need to talk about people.
Yeah. Thank you for that. Actually, as it is said, there is a lot of gaps. So it's a work ground for us. Like, we have so much opportunity to improve upon that and work in that area. Yeah, in future, we should think about it and say, like, as Akshay sir told, it's not so good if you go in the traditional path or whatever. But I don't know. one thing that matters is if you have interest and passion towards always, like, what you want to achieve finally. It's not about, like, whether we are narrowing down into something or, like, whatever. It's up to us whether we can make time in future, like, on what kind of topics we want to work on, probably the projects. And as there is so much of a gap, like, it's the future. It's the hers who can change in future. So it's a good opportunity that we can do many projects or whatever, take guidance from the people, like so many inspiring people who are working now. We can do that. I think so. We can do something different, creative, so that it'll help to reduce that gap, that the rural urban thing, and quality of healthcare. Even the urban quality of healthcare is going down nowadays. So everything upon us. So first we have to assess the quality, what quality is going. So it depends on so much of research, doing many projects and inspiring our other friends and getting inspired, that and all it involves. So let's see in future.
Yeah. And
Go ahead, Savinita.
So I was just going to say that, like Azad, you just said, right, there is a huge gap and there's less manpower in rural areas. I feel that's exactly why we need such a platform in which we can connect to doctors or other individuals who are working in the healthcare system in rural area, so that to address problem, right, we can think out of the box. If there are people in diverse group here, right? Yeah, so there are people working in a technology forefront. I work in a genetic with genetic diseases. So you can address problem in much better way, like rather than ways in which we already know. Like, because I've been interacting with them, right, I got to know about a concept called social accountability. Like in the webinar just that you had shared, right, Swati?
Mm-hmm.
So this is how it's already, I mean, because it started as few individuals and how it's benefiting each other already, right? This is just a growing, as the simplest way is that we just learn from each other and learn how to deal with problems like healthcare problems in innovative ways.
So all that matters in this movement, in this group, whatever, if we have the same goal, like the primary healthcare movement, to work towards that. If that is there, like we can just go on, like knowing about it, get a proper knowledge, and if we have any ideas, we can apply with the help of you guys or something. So yeah, it is a big hope on future. Let's see. But even though I want to do PG, but I'm really committed to whatever primary healthcare and research thing and all. So
now that you set goals, right, now I think Swati, actually, we should talk about the values now.
Yeah, sure, we'll do that. I just wanted to point out, Anuradha, that I think we should think of primary healthcare in a broader sense, where we are not saying primary healthcare is different from specialty care or taking a PG. Taking a PG is absolutely fine, and we need specialists. But the thing is, what is happening, I mean, you know what is happening, right? As soon as MBBS, without thinking of what they want to achieve in their career or what they want to contribute to the society, we are getting into PG, we are getting into specialties, because that, I mean, the idea I thought after discussing with people is that it's more secure, you are in a path that will help you get a better job, better salary, etc., etc. But I'm sure your attitude is not that, but you have an understanding of what you want to do and where you want to head, what contribution you want to make in the society, what makes that specialty better. So primary healthcare is not just PHC, being a medical officer in a rural center or in an urban center, or being in a being the general practitioner, but it's more of an attitude. I'm taking the same example as what Savinita stated last few minutes back, of if you're a surgeon sitting in your clinic, you saw 5 patients coming with perforation, you think about what might be the cause in the community. You might think, oh, maybe typhoid is going on a lot, maybe we should work on that to prevent this. So that's an attitude of thinking of a disease not just as a disease, but about the person, about the community, which need not restrict to any specialty or anything. So to tell about a speech that we recently heard in IPH Annual Day, Institute of Public Health, this person, Dr. Ravi Narayan, his speech was titled, "Are you a floor mopper or a tap turner?" So like, are you trying to mop up all the diseases as and when they come and try, you're thinking you're doing your best, or are you trying to prevent certain things? You're trying to work on other things that are causing this poverty. It could be discrimination, it could be bias, it could be anything, even doctor violence against doctors. A lot of issues will affect healthcare, and just by keeping our minds open to them as not outside our discipline, but being active in discussions, in trying to see what we can do towards all of this to certain extent is what we thought would be
actually when we go through the values, it will be really, really clear, because it's very simple. The entire movement is only about these values. If one imbibes these values in their life, they automatically become a member of the movement, or you know, someone that is the work is done, half done already. Because I mean, if you actually imbibe, so let's go through this one by one. So
just before that, Anuradha and Nasid, me, Savinita, and Akshay had just done a discussion on call, and we had written this down. So anytime you feel something is contradicting or not in line, or want to add something, pitch in.
Yeah.
So the values are really simple. Humanness. So human. So realizing that we're all humans, and that everyone. That everyone is human. I mean, you get the point. It's really something that kind of summarizes the entire concept, wherein we realize the value of being a human and the importance, or the enormous amount of fortune that we have because of being born as humans, and to you know, respect that value and respect each other and work for each other on, or do things for each other. So those things are, that is the first value that has been listed. I don't know why that has been listed, but coincidentally. So,
if I can just add to that, right? I feel we, can you hear me?
Yes. Yeah.
So I think we need to keep that value in our mind. I mean, we need to, constantly, because if we don't, right, we'd forget that. Okay, I don't know. It's just automatically coming your example. So think of a surgeon's point of view, right? If you do like a below knee amputation, so many times we don't even care about the person, so many healthcare needs, right? Which goes after you do a below knee amputation. Suppose his occupation depends on vocal activity, like daily activities. And if you randomly do an amputation without addressing all those needs, right? You don't go further. But if we, it's kept in the back of that mind that to actually think of them as humans, with individuals with healthcare problems, rather than just labeling them as patient, right? We can address them better. Like, yeah. Am I making sense? So,
The other value is that just being cognizant of that is not enough. And there should be active participation in making sure. So I mean, this is really important for me, at least, because I have been a talker for a long time, and I've felt really bored of myself listening to myself talk about things and not do anything about it. So I mean, that should actually be the value of the entire movement, so that people do not get into that vicious cycle of you know, talking, and just complaining. So this should not be a passive movement at all. I mean, there is no point in building a passive movement. That will only add more noise to the already sound polluted world. So that way, this is the second value. And then
just to add to that, I mean, being active could be different to different people. Like role of a medical graduate would be different from a person who is still in medical school. So it might be in their own ways, but being active is what.
Yeah. What Swati said just now is the point number 4, right?
Yes.
4 is. So I'll tell that point when you are coming to 4. So participatory approach and shared decision making in terms of defining the problems and even the solutions used. This is kind of, I mean, this can be applied at multiple levels. Essentially, the idea is from, again, the humanness and respect for each other. How do you design or think about problems in a shared way, or a participatory approach?
One second, I think have the, okay, they're here.
So that's the focus of this. I mean, that's the way we can you know, bring this into practice. If you are working for someone, how do you bring them into your work? Like, how do you engage with them and make sure the decisions are shared, and that you are working for someone, you're not working. I mean, they are, you're not just working so that it becomes beneficial. Like, there's a difference between participatory approach and not so participatory approach, and shared decision making and imposed decision making. So, I mean, we can go into the details of that, but I am sure you are all aware of what we are talking about. And then
one example for that. So recently, we met this person who started Tribal Health Initiative, and in one of the videos, they were describing how a patient who had a fracture in the thumb of a hand, and he was a tribal man. So the doctor was trying to explain him that so we need to do a surgery. We need to put a K wire and immobilize it for a while, otherwise you have deformity or restricted mobility. And he asked him, if I don't do that, what will happen? He said the same thing, that you might not be able to move it to the complete extent where possible to. And that is what is going to happen. Like, I'm okay with that, so I don't need the K-wire. And the doctor just agreed to it. Because I think that was like shared decision making codes.
So with that, right? By participating the other community members or a patient, right? We might not reach a medically valid reason. It might not be medically right, but in human right thinking, like in a social thinking, it might be right to him, because it's at the end of it, respecting that individual here.
And that is exactly the core values of primary healthcare, wherein you respect the individual as a whole and not just as the fractured bone holder. And then there is actively participate in the primary healthcare needs that are pertinent to us or themselves. This is one really nice point in that this actually prevents us from getting distracted by things that we, by 1,000 battles. There will be 1,000 battles going around, and this will make us focus on what we are concerned about or what we can do something about. So if we, every day there are a million things that come into our mind or that we could potentially be a part of the problem or solution of, but then there are some things which are like really central to our problems, or it could be because of a geographical location or our qualification or our privilege or whatever, or our what is the opposite of privilege, or unfortunateness. So if I am suffering from a particular mental health condition or a physical health condition, I am probably going to be able to start a community of people who are suffering from that, or to build a group that demands accountability or a proper care system for that. So those kinds of things which are pertinent or passion or relevant to an individual, those are things our movement should make people focus on, and not some the entire movement writes about Kashmir, and then we can keep writing about 100 things, but that doesn't probably, I mean, there are so this is one thing that differentiates us from other movements in some ways. There are a lot of movements in India, in the world, where people write about things or, so much of things. But it becomes very special if we are actually doing things that are right in front of us, and then we can do something about it and write about it. So that's one thing. And then we actually go to, so these four are like, global values. And then we go into specific, way we talk to each other or interact. So there is mutual forgiveness and respect for fellow members, which means the same, like humanness and how we are respectful to the community or people all over. But again, once more, just stressing on the fact that inside the group itself, where there could be differences in approach or differences in opinion, we will forgive each other and understand each other and respect each other. So that kind of attitude. And then openness for learning and unlearning, essentially an attribute that will help you succeed. I think that's kind of self-explanatory. And the link here, I think, is about what code of conduct should be. Did you put it, Savanita? Can you just?
Sure, it's fine. I'll just tell it to them because I think it's already 50 minutes. So briefly, right, that link just tells how the Me Too movement started, right? And when it started, many individuals didn't know how they had to like talk with women. They didn't know what exactly is right, mere touching them or not. So that's why those two values, to understand that we all have come from a different upbringing, we all work in different work environment, so our thinking might be different, right? So that's why it's to understand that we all are in a journey of learning, and that's why forgiveness comes. So that's a very specific thing related to the above two values, related to with respect to feminism and the Me Too movement. You guys can, Akshay will share this, right? This
yeah.
For you check later.
The next point is also very similar to what just Savanita told. There will always be issues of privilege and power differences in the society, and in any interaction between whoever the participants are, there will be some amount of that dynamics coming into play, and we will be aware of it and accommodate that when interacting with others. That may be by being kind to one another, or by, you know, staying silent even though one has a value at times, with the power dynamic in mind. And then sometimes so all that's what accommodation means, while at the same time not patronizing people. So patronizing kind of takes away agency from people, wherein people could say you are from a particularly oppressed category, so you deserve to stand up and speak. And that kind of makes them feel, you know, you get, when you put the spotlight on them by patronizing them, and that again, you know, beats the purpose. So that is one. And then I think taking action responsibility here is just a repeat of what we discussed in the earlier. And then despite all this, there will be sometimes conflict where I think so there could still be conflict where we say if we act for the patient, right, it may turn out to be harmful for the doctor, or say we act for the doctor, it may turn out to be harmful for the patient. So why this happens? Because we have not considered the opinion of all the stakeholders. We have not included all the stakeholders. But it may be possible with multi-party engagement and all that to bring an approach or a solution or an approach that may be beneficial or reduces the total harm. And even in despite trying our best to do something that's good for everyone, if you're not able to come up with something, there is no way to prescribe a solution to that. We just have to act based on what our own conscience tells us. So that is if there's a better way to word all this, please suggest. And then at the end, we have just written, I nurture, scientific temper, but never at the cost of humanity or ethics. In that scientific rigor and all that is absolutely necessary, but we never forget our first value, which is humanness, and that's the kind of thing we have come up with right now.
Anuradha, if you have to bring your bag, you please do that.
I did that already went like
so do you think after hearing about these values, do you think there is some do you feel, do you understand, or do you get it, like what is this, Anta?
Probably not 100%, but like everything is like that, no, in starting, like we don't actually know what exactly it is, but when you start and we probably like have a chart like a couple of times, other times we'll understand proper. Like for now, like how to conduct, like what about it is, and like some things are clear. But yeah, we'll learn that. gradually. But and probably,
yeah, go ahead.
Probably for the, like, say, the next meetings or next talks, whatever, things will be clearer, like, we'll have a better idea.
So, I mean, this is entirely contextual. So, for the points I wrote or I kind of shaped, it will be completely transparent to me what it means. But then the points that probably Swati brought in or Savinita brought in, I also may be not able to understand why we wrote this or what it means. So our interpretation of things will be contextual to our own actions and activities and life. And that will remain the same whenever whoever joins. And the only way we can overcome that is by ourselves setting examples which are more easier to understand. Values are also easy to understand if you are already doing a lot of things and you get the context. But otherwise, when we set examples, that are easier for people who are totally new to this to process. Yeah. So it's important that we as the beginning people, like you, Asad, Savinita, that guy from Ethiopia, everyone have things that we can show others and inspire, I mean, make them understand.
Thank you.
And
that's
very important. Just one point. I'm happy that having this conversation even before we all are clear on what this stands for, because shared, this shared acting upon whatever was one of the values, I think this is one of the things that we are doing in line with that value, where we're shaping this whole movement with a shared understanding of what we would want it to be and what it means to each of us.
Yeah. I think when we wrote the values, right, we should, like he said, give examples now so that other people who join in can understand. We should make it a bit context specific to whichever value we understand. And yeah, that's all. Because anyhow, you're explaining, telling examples, right? Might just write there, like, if it's too
long.
Actually, like in future, when we take up a specific goals or something like that, like when we have, like when we do our homework to try to know about that thing, what we can do about that things will be better, like, understood. But now what we learn, just respect each other, like respect each other knowledge, help each other. That's the thing I feel.
True. So actually, whatever you get into, we can discuss how this comes into practice. Only
we even put a heading with activities, and we thought we'd discuss maybe a few things that we can start off with. So if you have any suggestions, let's spend maybe 5 minutes at least on that.
It's like, I think we should give our time, we should take our time to lay out what our goals and objectives are. If we kind of hurry up or like randomly shoot something in the air, like we might not change it in future. Like, it's important like to know what our goals are, and like working on something else like immediately right away, something we have in our mind. So like framing a goal question or like what's the idea, I think we should take more time for that.
So like how there are book clubs all over the world, right? Like in that book clubs, people will say that, okay, let's read about this book and then discuss it. We can like discuss research works, you know, like prominent and not so prominent research works in public health field, which has been happened in the world, and like maybe someone of us can like share a link and then all of us can go through it and then discuss it. And because we work in different spheres, right, we can talk about it in many different ways, angles to it, and that's how we can learn also, right, already prevalent problems that we are interested in.
Laying out goals and objectives, it need not be like very specific. I remember how vague my ideas were, and to a certain extent still vague, but at least I know some direction to take. And if we articulate that direction or what we would 5 years.
The one of the we would be if we set our goals and objectives in stone right now, it would be kind of against one of our own principles of engaging the shareholders and participatory approach. In the sense, we still haven't engaged with our own community members. We are only 13 people in the group now.
Yeah.
So, it's always if it's going to be participatory, then people should always have that opportunity to come in and shape that and all that. So
that's like personal goals and objectives.
Oh, you're talking about personal goals and objectives, Asad? Were you, Asad?
What?
Are you talking about personal goals and objectives?
No, not personal. Like what this group is for? Like, since we're talking about primary healthcare, it's not a small thing. Like,
yeah.
If we lay out one goal, we kind of narrowing our field of like working area and interest, like what Swati told, like it shouldn't be specific. Like, the way I observed Anuradha, she wants it to be specific. That's good.
No, not like that exactly. Like, I didn't mean to say, like, let it be specific from the first. See, like, as you guys telling, it's a movement. Like, before doing any research paper, like, we go through many things, many journals. We will be narrowed down. At this topic, I want to go. And under this topic, like, probably this kind of thing I want to do. It's not, like, very specific. But, like, a general idea. This is the first time ever I'm involving this kind of thing. I don't exactly know how it's going to work. Like, that's what I was thinking about. Like, just, like, all of us should work upon that. And, like, say, like, choose some areas, like, on what we can concentrate and like how exactly we can do. It's not like this movement is like a real thing, right? It's not like we're gonna chat about it or like do a debate or not like that. Like, we are expecting some output. Like, let's all of us work and plan. And like, that's what, like, it only happens when all of us get involved and try to acquire knowledge first and then have some idea. I currently don't have much idea except the primary healthcare, which I studied in Park, which I did know little. I didn't even work outside. Like, I just finished my internship and I'm with the books right now. So it's you guys teaching us, even we are like with interest exploring the things, all of the things gonna matter. That's what I'm not seeing the specific, at least it should lead to some output, like say creating a very inspired person so that they'll go make some change in the society, as you guys are telling.
So
please do forgive if it didn't make sense, but like, I don't know exactly how it's gonna work. Like, I really don't know. For now, I'm talking to you guys, that's all I know.
It's like, I think none of us know.
Yeah,
like, all of us are in like that only. Like, we are also like trying out new things, and so all of us are equally clueless.
Generally, like, if it's a work, like it's a clinical thing, or there is a project, that will be something like this, as you guys told, it's a movement or something, like, we should formulate, like, build a plan. That's what my thing was.
I'll just give you a few tangential thoughts. One is that there are activities, and activities can be of different kinds. One is individual activities, wherein a person who is in this community or who is not even identifying themselves as a member of this community can still be doing some activity that will be very much in line with primary healthcare movement.
Yeah.
That is an individual activity. Then there can be group activities wherein we as a community are working together to do something that is towards the goals, like say setting up a website for making people aware of what primary healthcare is, how to do that, or building resources, or connecting people, building a directory of people who are in that. So that can be group activities, okay? And then we have to differentiate all that activities from objectives. So for a movement, there need not be any objectives. I'll just take the example of Me Too, which has been over abused by our conference call as examples. But that movement, if you take, there's no one objective for it. I mean, there's a broad objective that there should be gender equality and that people should not suffer in silence forever. But it's not like we will have n number of people brought out, or that you know, this is about bringing. I mean, there's a direction that is true. It may not be a specific activity or an objective that is mentioned as a direction. So I mean, it's all similar, and we can do all of those. We can have global objectives that are broad, and then we can have group activities that many of us participate in, and then we can also have individual activities where, or subgroups where some people are interested into education, some people are interested into health, or some people are interested in preparing for PG and to work together. So I mean, all that can be done as group, that can also be done. So I mean, I'm just bringing those contexts into the picture. So I think we've had a very effective 1 hour.
Yeah. Anything else, any other thoughts that needs to be discussed?
Yeah. I think as individuals, when we talk about ourselves, like we are medical graduates, right? We are very strong as individuals. Like sometime in future, let's say Anuradha is going to be a surgeon. She's like even stronger, like individually speaking. Like in her community, she's going to be a very good surgeon sometime in future. So this is what output you can take from this group that might help or shape you, that might do your, like let you do your part. Like while you're working or like anything you want to do, the input exactly. Is like what Akshay said, is the community and global participation. Like I think that's the input we should try to do in this group. Output is for yourself. You should never like I think you should follow your goals, your dreams, to what you want to do. Help like yourselves. Like even like someone studying for, let's say, a cardiothoracic surgery, that's great. We are achieving a one great cardiothoracic surgeon like in our country. Even though like it's a very narrow field, that's for him. So as a doctor, he's strong. As a group, we are not like stronger or strongest. We are just strong. Like I mean to say, like medical field, like as group and as doctors, we are like stronger than most of the things. Yeah, input and output. Input is for the global and community participation. Output should be for yourselves. Like you might take some other field in future, that should be your objective, should be to use that field and your area of interest and your expertise to help primary care.
It's recorded.
I think he has put it like right precisely that so why the outcome might not be predefined is because it's happening through people. So we should focus on building people and building attitude, which might result in unpredictable outcomes. And that's, yeah. So maybe direction and mission is something that we can define, but not exactly outcomes.
Yeah. I have this one question. Since you guys know more, like I haven't really check the technical part. Whenever you say something as a movement, how exactly it's going to work, like all the other movements which are start by others, how exactly they would start and they would go about it, I never really checked like how that process works. Do you guys know about it?
So a movement, yeah, please.
So okay, I'm going to use the, I don't know many movements, and the common thing I know is actually Me Too. That's how I'll say, like before this Me Too movement, right, the patriarchy system which was existing in our society was so rampant. It was so normal for a woman to be submissive for in front of a man, right? We always presume that women are, like, they just presume that women are going to be bad surgeons, right? Oh, you can't hold for so long and all those things. It's just inbuilt. We don't even question it, right? So, with the Me Too movement, you start someone started questioning and someone started saying that, okay, this is something wrong which is happening, and I identify this, that just had happened to me. And then she just shared it, that like hashtag Me Too thing. And then everyone realized that they too share this common, they too have been victimized, right? So this was a very prevalent public problem. So everyone could easily catch up with the movement. It's so similar with primary healthcare, right? We, in even the primary, in the health system, there is a patriarchy system. Doctor just tells a patient to follow all these things. And there's so many things we don't even consider about patients' other healthcare value. We're like, we think of it as a job which needs to be done. So this problem of public healthcare is prevalent among all of us. So when we have certain research projects or certain case scenarios where primary healthcare is initiated, where we think beyond the problem of a patient, right? Think beyond that. It just, that moment just spreads when we realize that, okay, we should think like this also. Like, huh. That's how I got this realization couple of weeks back, actually, like, that because this need is there in all of us, you know, maybe by sharing that hashtag primary healthcare, or I don't know how it'll spread. So I actually did that, Swati. Like when you sent me that article now on Academy of Family Physicians, I put that hashtag primary healthcare.
I saw that.
So I'll give you another example of a movement. We all have heard of freedom movement of India. So when the British were ruling India, it's not, the agenda is not set by any particular team or group or leader or individuals. When people are aware of the entire vision, so they're united by a opposing, they're united by a goal or an objective. So that's how movements are. The leaders are immaterial people who started. We don't even know who started the freedom movement because it would have started in multiple places in multiple ways. The only end goal we remember is that we got freedom. So, and there would have been some leaders who became famous in that, and that's natural. So this is similar. People are aware of the need for health and how it's not working out at the moment, and so it's just I mean, sometimes doctors are not aware. I sometimes feel but still, if we I mean, it's about that, it's just about igniting that fire, and then it will just spread, and hashtags, people will start using hashtags. They just have to get it
because we're all aware of it, right? And it's so existent. You just told about the rural and urban inequality and how we can't even address those things, and it's there in all our fields.
All the problems should be strategically addressed or whatever. We can be a better physicians or a better doctor, best doctors at individual level. Like, what we can think of a creative ways to make a change in a large, like, that should come from us, like us discussing with each other, like getting creative, whatever. Like, I think more we know about it, more we talk about it, probably we're going to get a good ideas for it.
Excellent.
Yeah. And that's one of the activities, right? Journal clubs and discussing works.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you guys want to keep that as
and
the
that's
next
how you inspire.
Which one?
Yeah, like, do you want to keep that as the next activity, like discussing some work pertinent to all of us?
Yeah, that can be done actually.
Book, or should we start with the small thing, like a case?
Journal.
Anything.
Like NEJM has this. NEJM has this cases in social medicine thing.
Yeah.
Where interesting cases are present, social medicine cases. They're like really, really eye opening.
Sure.
Yeah.
Maybe,
like, if we start with an individual case or an individual article, it would be easy initially, rather than going from multiple journals and topics.
I agree with you, Anurag. It will help us understand what each of us are talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Once we get on to one specific topic, and
okay, sounds great.
In terms of what movement means, technically, it doesn't have any legal entity as such. It's more of people coming together for a cause, and it defines what we stand for. It defines who we are, what work we get done, that kind of a thing.
Thank you. I'm sorry for being stupid. I don't know.
No, we actually looked up the definition while we were trying to name this thing. So we're all on the same page.
Okay.
I really liked what Swati meant by building attitude among medical professionals. That's important because having that attitude that you can acknowledge that primary care is a need in India or anywhere else for that matter. Like, if you have that, like, as individual, they can do more. Like, acknowledgement is, like, you should have acknowledgement. But now we have
a very important part. I say, like, today for a 13 group members, only like 5 was here. Like, we should like make our friends realize or whatever, like how important it is. It's not only preparing for an entrance or like probably achieving as personal goals. Akshay sir was telling, it's more important because we have such a gap, such an opportunity to improve the things. We should be inspiring other people to understand, and we should also get better. And like, that's what I feel like, inspiring others to do it and understand about it is a very important thing too. Because so many of us, I feel like so much ignorant. They say UG students are very busy with attending quizzes, conferences. I don't know what they want to do. Like that, I feel like it's the very WHO. Even though I took like last year and this year both universal healthcare as a part of the World Health Day theme, like nobody even think about the importance of it. Like especially in a country like India, it's not like we're talking about US or UK where we have like very good established healthcare system, where they only have a problem with insurance, money, that stuff and all. We have like so much problems. If you have a problem, that means we have an opportunity to improve better. So I think what I feel, I should inspire my friends and the UG students so that like they will know, yeah, this is a field, this is an opportunity that we should be thinking about it too, rather than just say becoming a specialist. That's what I was telling about. Like all of us just say we get a specialty and go and work at individual level, which we may not be sure like how good of output we can give. When we work for a larger cause, it would help.
True.
This is what I have seen, like in a hierarchy from a HOD to professor to first year medical student, there's a very good hierarchy like vertically, but there's no connectivity or network like horizontally. Like we don't know what like our people, yeah, like our classmates or like others, like what they're thinking.
We know how, yeah.
No? Yeah. There's no horizontal, you know, connectivity.
Too much, nothing at all. Like it should change, like we should try to change little by little and like our whatever. There is so much to change, I think. So
like so, Facebook, when you have a network of connectivity, like you can address a big, small or big issue in a good way. And like you can really solve it. So the connectivity,
yeah, we're really looking to build it in a larger way, in a more inspiring way. Like as I told, yeah, goals cannot be predefined, so it's a good thing. We don't know what we're gonna get out of it, so let's work together.
The only way to build the movement is through action. You know, you can't inspire people. The only way to inspire is by showing them.
But that is there. Like to form action, we need people. To need people, we should really educate about them about it. Like until unless I was involved with a conversation with you guys, I didn't. That should be a part, I think. So I didn't exactly know how to approach. Like what exactly we are doing. Like what exactly is this, right? Like that part should be that rise. Yes, of course, action is the important thing which you told. Like not complaining, which you told initially. We are not supposed to complain. We're supposed to work. But yeah, but we'll drag our friends anyway into
that's
this.
That's cleverly put in there.
Yeah.
Please do invite your friends.
Yeah, sure.
Yes. Yeah.
And all this is action. Like talking about it is also action. Like quality of it, but it's like levels of evidence. The better you can do, the better. The whatever you do is still action.
So can we set a date for that discussion on our case study for coming week?
Hey, did I miss something? Not really.
Not really. No. Okay, there's cool. There's a very interesting case on abdominal pain. I mean, I have written about it. You may have read about it, but still, we can discuss that again. It's a social medicine case where someone comes with abdominal pain, it has a really interesting diagnosis. So we can discuss that on Thursday. Thursday? I don't know. What is a free
share
day?
Share that case on the group so that.
Yes. That can be done.
And set the date and time.
Let's choose a date after asking everyone in the group.
Sure. And that will be again an interactive video session, right?
Let's do it that way. That sounds okay.
Better rather than just messaging in the group. I don't know. Like video session would be better.
Yes.
So we just have to be cognizant that for some people access to a video chat may be limited, and therefore
yeah. And people can come join whenever they want to. That's the
Yeah, I also plan to put it up on YouTube, whatever discussion we do. I don't see it why we need not put it out.
Yeah, okay. We should. I think so. Yeah.
Okay. Can we end this call now?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you so much, guys.
It was nice meeting you.
Thank you all.
Bye.
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 Now, Anuradha.
Excuse what?